Monia welcomes you. This is Humaira, and in today's video, we will be talking about how COVID has affected us mentally. Following a healthy diet and having a healthy lifestyle is not enough if you are not having a healthy mindset. You need to take care of your mental health, only then you will be completely called a healthy human being. Nobody thought that a time would come where people would struggle to get oxygen. You know, now we are paying to get oxygen. It is not for free. It is something we took for granted. I know you want to be independent. I know you don't require anyone's help. You can do this on your own because you're doing everything else on your own. So here are a few tips for you so that you can calm yourself down whenever during the day or at night you feel agitated or things are out of control. So the first thing that we can try doing is meditate or doing self-care. I have mentioned this before also. I have stressed on the fact that we have to do a deep breathing, we have to do things that we like, but that actually works. That is the reason why I keep stressing on it. And meditation, we all know we have to do breathing exercises, we have to drink some water, and you know there is an instant boost of energy that you will experience. When talking about self-care, it doesn't mean that you always have to apply a face mask or listen to a music and you will be fine. You can have your own definition. For example, when I feel stressed out, I start cleaning. Even though the room is clean, there's nothing to do, I start organizing, I start to declutter stuff. That is what makes me feel distracted, and in no time I feel better. The thing that we should try to do is show gratitude. We don't realize the loss of something until and unless we actually lose it, whether it's a person or something about your health. We must just close our eyes and analyze about everything inside our body that is happening so smoothly. The exchange of gases, the pumping of blood from the heart to the arteries into all of the body parts, the digestion of food, the removal of waste from the body. There is so much that can go wrong right now, but it isn't. When you analyze what is happening internally and how everything is taken care of without you doing anything, you will feel gratitude and you'll feel grateful instantly. You should actually try to understand where, okay, one parameter will not be working. Maybe parameter A is not fit right now. But think about the other parameters. They are working absolutely fine. You are still able to live. You're able to breathe. Next thing that we can do is be productive. When you make a note of everything that you did throughout the day, you will be able to actually have an insight of it. You will be able to analyze whether you did things right or you did things wrong. When you see that at the end of the day, you will be able to analyze what you are doing, where do you stand. Next and one is my go-to mantra, and it instantly helps. Praying. Obviously, we pray to God, and the beauty of praying is that when you are venting out, when you're talking about your issues, there's nobody to judge you. There's nobody to pass comments on you. There is somebody who's patiently listening to you. When you talk about your issues to God, you know that something is taken care of by Him and you don't have to worry about it. Once you are acknowledging the fact that I am talking to God, asking for His help, it makes you feel more assured that things are going to be fine. He is listening and He is going to help me. And we should. The next one, which is quite an important point, take break from social media. You should give yourself some time off these applications where people are posting about their lives, where they're telling where they're going or what they're eating. Because even though you know that what you see on social media is not completely true, we all are humans. There is a time where we might think, oh, we might come to this conclusion that, oh, this person is having so much fun. you should try to avoid using your phones, watching the news very frequently, because that is going to really get into your system. You will have a lot of negativity. I'm not saying that awareness is not important. Obviously, we have to be aware about what is happening around the world, but there should be a certain limit to that. Finally, the last point. Smile. You must be wondering, if somebody is agitated, how can they smile? Normally when you're agitated, you have a frown face, you look very grumpy, you look very irritated. But what you have to do is just go in front of the mirror and try to think of it as an exercise. Try to smile. So when you are putting that effort in smiling, you will instantly start thinking of your family or a good memory or things you like. When you smile, you forget that something was bothering you. Again, this does not mean that you are ignoring your issues, but this is a way to calm yourself. If you are not calm, if you're not in the right state of mind, how are you going to address your issues? So that is why I gave these 6 tips to you, so that you understand first how to calm yourself down, put yourself in the right mindset, and only then address. Cume all the negativity, jealousy, insecurity, frustration from your life. Because when you are stuffing yourself with dirt, it is just going to harm you, not others. You are just going to feel agitated and worried all the time. And that is going to stop you from doing something positive. You must realize that you are not alone. You are not fighting alone, but the entire world is fighting with you. We are fighting for breath, we are fighting for justice, for life. We are fighting against those who do bad deeds, those who do not have any humanity. We are fighting against the virus. We all are one, and we are together in life. That is all for today. I will see you all next Sunday. Do like, share, subscribe, and comment. Until then, love, invest, find yourself, and enjoy.